Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, DJ Manopo.
Good morning, Nikki. Here are the top stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community here in North America.
As the world registered the hottest month of all time in July, the southwestern U.S. city of Phoenix shattered its own 1974 heatwave record, with temperatures above 110 degrees Fahrenheit for 31 straight days. Heat-sensitive photography in late July reveals an even hotter Phoenix, where concrete on the street registered 150 degrees Fahrenheit, and homeless people were surrounded by surfaces as hot as 143 degrees Fahrenheit. This Phoenix doctor says his hospital has been inundated by patients suffering from heat stroke, sometimes life-threatening. Workers say sometimes people pass out on the scalding pavement, suffering serious burns on their bodies.
Am I worried? Of course I'm worried. Unfortunately, many people in Arizona don't have air conditioning, and many people are homeless. And we saw about half of our patients who come in this comatose state are homeless.
Maricopa County, where Phoenix is located, reported 39 confirmed heat-associated deaths by the end of July, with over 300 more under investigation to determine if they were caused by heat.
Meanwhile, at the Los Angeles International Airport, one NBA star is headed to the Philippines to join Gilas for the World Cup.
On Sunday night, Filipino-American Utah Jazz guard Jordan Clarkson departed from LAX to Manila, where Team Philippines is scheduled to begin training camp in preparation for the FIBA Basketball World Cup, scheduled for August 25 to September 10, hosted in the Philippines, Japan, and Indonesia. While Clarkson didn't speak much as he checked in and boarded, he was all smiles and expressed his excitement to head over to the Philippines.
Are you excited to get out there?
Yeah, we've been waiting.
Clarkson posted a few selfies as he made his way through the terminal. The Philippines' first World Cup game is scheduled for August 25th against the Dominican Republic at the Philippine Arena. But Gilas will have a couple of exhibition games against Montenegro on August 20th and Mexico on the 21st.
And finally, we head to Surrey, British Columbia, where the mayor wants a Filipino cultural center to be built.
The mayor of Surrey wants a Filipino cultural center to be built in Surrey, the fifth largest city in Western Canada, and home to the largest population of Filipino Canadians in Metro Vancouver.
We really want to have it here in Surrey, don't you think? We're the
yeah!
I agree. It's our turn.
These Filipino residents held an extended celebration of Filipino Heritage Month through a two-day fiesta extravaganza. Consul General to Vancouver Arlene Magdaho appealed for unity in the wake of the confusion brought about by the presence of two organizations with overlapping interests in the Filipino Cultural Center.
I urge all Filipinos to be unified in pushing for the establishment of our own cultural center in British Columbia, a place for our community to come together and celebrate what it means to be Filipino.
And those are the top stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community. You can catch more of our stories on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews, and of course on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. And you can also download our app, ABS-CBN News, on the App Store. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to Nikki for the rundown.
Overseas, 5 people were killed while 31 more were wounded after 2 Russian missile strikes hit residential buildings in the Ukrainian city of Pokrovsk. Now, footage from Ukrainian officials showed people sorting through the rubble of a badly damaged 5-story apartment building. Ukraine's interior minister says 4 civilians died in the first attack. Search and rescue operations, meanwhile, are ongoing when the second attack hit, killing an emergency official. Despite the advances in artificial intelligence, there are still uncharted territories to explore. And this report takes a look at the possible economic impact of AI technology.
Will artificial intelligence be a blessing or a curse? History may be able to offer us a few clues.
A certain amount of fear is justified. I don't think we're facing the robot apocalypse, the Terminator scenario.
Take the medieval plough. If advances in the tool didn't lift Europe's peasants out of poverty, it was largely because their rulers took the wealth generated by the new gains in output and used it to build cathedrals instead. Economists say something similar could happen with artificial intelligence if it enters our lives in such a way that the benefits are enjoyed by the few, not the many.
AI definitely has the potential to increase inequality.
Simon Johnson is a professor of global economics and management at MIT Sloan School of Management.
It may benefit other people also, but that could also take a really long time. So a lot of times technological transformations eventually do help a lot of people, but eventually might be 100 years or even more. So I think the question with AI is how quickly can you share the benefits?
Backers of AI predict a productivity leap that will generate wealth and improve living standards. Consultancy McKinsey estimates that it could add between $14 trillion and $22 trillion of value annually. That higher figure being roughly the current size of the US economy. Some techno-optimists go further, suggesting that, along with robots, AI is the technology that will finally free humanity from humdrum tasks and launch us into lives of more creativity and leisure.
Based on the technology of automation.
Yet worries abound about its impact on livelihoods, including its potential to destroy jobs in all kinds of sectors. Witness the strike by Hollywood actors who fear being made redundant by their AI-generated doubles. 31-year-old Bell works in property.
I guess the people who've created it are worried about what they've created.
Such concerns are not unfounded. Innovation, it turns out, is the easy bit. Harder is making it work for everyone. History shows the economic impact of technological advances is generally uncertain, unequal, and sometimes outright malign. The track record of the internet, for example, is complex. It has created many new job roles, even as much of the wealth generated has gone to a handful of billionaires. But the productivity gains it was once lauded for have slowed down across many economies.
So AI is up there in terms of potential impact, but it's also really fast, right? It's coming at us much faster than electricity did. For example, that was a big deal in the early 20th century, but that took about 20 or 30 years to roll out fully. AI already, I mean, within a few days, ChatGPT was affecting jobs around the world. And I think within 5 years, the effects are going to be quite profound in many places.